Spoken Realms presents Moonblood by T.W. Fendley. Narrated by Amanda Leigh Jerry. Chapter 1. Airy. I raised my face and palms toward the sky, along with 50 other blue-eyed, black-haired women who encircled the crescent moon fountain. Unfettered by clothes, our pale brown skin drank in the moonlight and tanned to rich, dark hues. Our bodies fed on the moon song, created by a subtle shift in the airwaves that changed tempo as the moon climbed higher in the cloudless sky. Moonbathing pleased us as nothing else did, but even the full moon above couldn't quell my longing for something uniquely mine. I felt invisible, stifled by the sameness. We'd been here for hours, and I was growing impatient. To keep from looking toward the gymnasium and giving away my plan, I kept my mind busy thinking about moonbeams. Some said they were in our blood. I didn't know about that, but I didn't want to find out what a month without the full moon's rays might do to me. Older girls used to scare us with tales of women who'd been locked away in dungeons, or those who'd been touched in that way by a cane. Either could kill us outright, they said. I doubted the truth of such claims, but I still got the shivers. I imagined better outcomes of coming face to face with a cane, or perhaps even an atom. The matron said the compound's towering walls were to keep others out, but they also kept us in. I almost sighed with relief when caretakers went to the new moon fountain and escorted the younger girls to their rooms. Finally. The moon became less energizing as it passed the zenith, and the youngest felt its power ebb first. Before long, it was our group's time to leave. I walked toward our dorm behind the others, dropping back until I could slip into the shadows at the building's edge. Eventually, the compound grew dark and silent. I'd come to know the pattern over the past 6 months, since I first felt drawn to do what we were all warned against. After everyone was in bed, it was the perfect time to walk in the field. We were forbidden to go there alone at night, so that's where I longed to be. The matron said homeless canes sometimes wandered there from the city, and others came looking for a place to party, but I'd never seen anyone except our own sentries. From cloudy days spent exploring, I knew the field's secrets. A stream small enough to step across cut diagonally through the waist-high grass, making a home for frogs and turtles. Two-thirds of the way down the gravel road that bordered the property, a tiny oasis of sweet clover and wildflowers lay hidden among the taller grass. That was my destination, as it had been so many nights before. The field had gotten all tangled up with thoughts of freedom. Outside the compound, I didn't feel anonymous. I felt more myself, not just another crescent moon cadet. I'd figured out the best way to leave the compound was through the gate near the gymnasium. The sleeping areas were across the courtyard, so if anyone was still wandering about, they'd be less likely to notice me. Conveniently, the gymnasium bordered the field. I waited until the sentry crossed to the other side of the compound before I pushed against the heavy wooden gate. Iron hinges creaked as I slipped through. I paused for a few seconds and listened. All was quiet. I left the gate unlatched, but closed. Perhaps the openness of the field made the moonlight seem stronger, but I grew lightheaded with the rush of moonsong through my veins. I didn't waste any time getting to my secret haven, but I also let myself revel in the moment. I spread my arms and spun through the amber stalks, which brushed soft as feathers against my skin. When my feet finally touched the clover's springy softness, I dropped onto the fragrant earth. Violas cushioned my fall. A breeze rustled the stalks. I lay on my back and studied the sky. A falling star cut across the Big Dipper. Did it offer a wish or a warning? I wished not to be invisible anymore. I wished to be free. I thought things would change when I reached maturity and left the new moon group. But instead of more freedom...
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.